This is an extract of the data model for Automotive Cloud from Salesforce. Specifically, this one has to do with the product and vehicle and related objects. Now, at the heart are the product and the asset objects. Now, both of these are standard Salesforce objects that we are all familiar with as Salesforce practitioners. The product represents very simply an item that can be sold to a customer. So in the case of automotive industry, this could be a car, a truck, or even a part or an accessory or a spare part and so on. Now, the product stores attributes like description, make, model, year, and so on. And in order to organize and classify the products, what is not shown in this picture, but you do have access to constructs like catalogs, product categories, bundles, and so on, which typically act as guardrails for the sellers when they are configuring the products and putting the options together on a vehicle, for example. Now, common for car companies is to sell their products under different brand names so that they are targeting different customer segments with these distinct brand names. So, for example, you might have a brand name for your SUVs and another one for your sports cars or your luxury cars and so on. And that is what is captured in this table here. So what's an asset in contrast to the product? The asset carries information of a product that has been sold. So a vehicle that has been sold to a customer, or a part or an accessory that is installed or sold as a spare part. Now, every vehicle is an asset, but not all assets or assets are more than just the vehicles. An asset milestone, on the other hand, is a construct unique to Automotive Cloud. And this asset milestone tracks key events in an asset's life cycle. For example, a series of events could be that it first arrived at a dealer's location. It then got readied to be carried in the lot. For customers to come and see and buy. It gets sold, and then it is also tracked after being sold for when it comes back for maintenance and repairs and so on. The asset warranty is referring to the warranty typically from a manufacturer. The asset relationship object is capturing how an asset, say a part, maybe a replacement part or a substitute or an upgrade. So what is its relation? What is the relationship between an asset with another? Asset is, of course, part of the core Salesforce data model. And you'll see as you take a broader view to the automotive data model at large, you'll see that the asset object has relationships that are already in place with objects like service appointment or the service resource or the technician working on a repair job or a work order that represents a repair or a recurring maintenance job. The vehicle represents the specific instance and carries information like the owner, the vehicle identification number, the VIN number, the chassis number perhaps, and related to it, to the vehicle object, are related objects like inspections, which are carrying information on car on the vehicle inspections and so on. The vehicle definition is, think of it as a construct that has been broken out from the vehicle into a special object, into a separate object, and it may carry information like this is a two-door or a four-door vehicle, and that the transmission is an automatic transmission, or if it's an EV, maybe information about the battery capacity, the battery type, and so on. So hope that gives you a glimpse of how the product information is represented in Automotive Cloud. Look forward to seeing you in another Warasi video.